Currently, all the money we spend on oil disappears into a few super-rich oil-producing multinationals and countries. Imagine that instead all this money goes to rural regions worldwide. It will stimulate the regional economies with new employment and innovations. So you might say a bio-based economy is really about economics. And since it also is about improving livelihoods, working on sustainability and innovations, it is a rewarding topic. In this lesson, we shall consider the aspects that may feel circumstantial for technically oriented persons. However, for policymakers, economists, and entrepreneurs, these aspects are paramount. In this module, you will learn about business, the economy, and investments. Do you remember why we want to establish a bio-based economy? Replacing fossil-based energy and materials helps to save on feedstock usage. It reduces emissions of greenhouse gases and mitigates climate change. It can also help establish economic advantages through innovation and reviving regional and rural economies. One of the main goals in the bio-based economy is to realize value added or profit. The pyramid of products illustrates the idea that some products have a higher value added than others. From an economic perspective, it may be wise to pursue the higher pathways for any given feedstock. Yet, when working in biomass production chains, it is hardly possible to focus on one end product alone. The business case and the greenhouse gas emissions both depend on the entire supply chain, and they depend on the summation of all the different main and side products that are produced from the biomass. For example, if you consider to produce biogas, you should have a good plan to put the remaining digestate to good use. Otherwise, you may not be allowed to sell it or make very high costs to get rid of it. In many cases, new bio-based applications are developed from an existing supply chain, mostly food or forestry production chains, as an upside option for a main product or a residual. If done correctly, the business case and the emission profile of the entire supply chain is then improved. For instance, producing biogas from the side products of the sugar factory will yield energy that can be used in the factory. Societies and governments have even higher ambitions, which since 2015 are contained in the Sustainable Development Goals. We have quite a challenge ahead if we want to achieve our goals. Bio-based energy and products are a part of the solution. Therefore, governments worldwide apply different instruments to create a market for these products and provoke private investment. They imply quota, production subsidies, and fiscal measures. This may level the playing field as compared to fossil alternatives, of which the negative effects are not incorporated in the prices. In doing so, they help bio-based markets to start or scale up. One aspect that is particular to bio-based business cases is the dependence on feedstock. Is it available in high enough volumes and at low enough costs? If residuals are your focus, they may not be available all year round. Crops prices are seasonal. Every feedstock comes with a price, and in the end, you may find yourself competing with yourself. I'll give you one example. In the Netherlands, pig manure is in surplus. Farmers are not allowed to apply a large part of the volume for environmental reasons. Therefore, they offer the manure on the market with a premium. A Dutch energy company was considering investing in a large-scale manure processor, but it had to reckon with a 50% decrease in the feedstock premium as a result of their entering the market, which greatly influenced their business case. When farmer cooperatives begin to deliver to chemical industries, or when individual farmers start to produce energy from biogas, they pursue a new product and a new market at the same time. In the strategy model of ANSOF, such diversification is identified as the riskiest strategy, also known as the suicide cell. The strategy requires completely new capabilities, new techniques, and new facilities. As a result, this leads almost inevitably to physical and organizational changes in the company structures and relationships. This complexity is one rationale to look for the easier so-called drop-in solutions. For instance, chemical production chains look for bio-based chemicals that are an exact replacement for former fossil chemicals. This way, they continue using the same facilities, the same processes and infrastructure, yet because drop-ins are so comparable, they are often competing on price alone. And new bio-based products are generally more expensive than fossil products that may have been optimized for centuries. To decrease the initial cost price and to scale up production, it is important to have a motivated launching customer. This is a customer which guarantees a first production volume so that the producer is able to launch the new product. For example, the plant bottle initiated by Coca-Cola was a driver for Aventium to scale up production of its new material PEF. Also, minimum quota of fiscal measures by governments may create a launching market. It is important, however, to realize that such premiums are temporary. When Germany, by means of excise exemption, built a remarkable volume in the biodiesel market, it proved too expensive. The exemption was lifted and the biodiesel market collapsed within months. Looking back on this part of the course, we found that it is important to find a business case for every part of your biomass. Biomass feedstock is an essentially different game than fossil feedstock. Governments may stimulate investments and market uptake up to a certain level. Bio-based innovations are challenging and it is necessary to partner with a launching customer. This lesson has provided you with both an economic motivation, the value added, and an economic precondition, investability, for the bio-based economy. Bio-based applications may give us better value added to our biomass production chain, and it is often on the basis of a launching customer that investments in scale-up of production are justified. This was only a brief introduction in some business aspects of bio-based applications. If you are particularly interested in the business aspects of bio-based economy, we offer an online specialization course called Bio-based Business Development. So, is the bio-based economy really about economics? With economics being both a motivation and a precondition for bio-based developments, you might righteously say so.